Zechariah and his wife, Elizabeth, were old and had no children. They lived outside of Jerusalem in the hill country and did what was right. Zechariah was a priest, and at that time, King Herod ruled over Judea. Twice a year, Zechariah went to the temple in Jerusalem to carry out his duties as a priest. Many priests served in the temple. One day, Zechariah was chosen to go into the sanctuary of the Lord and burn incense. People gathered outside to pray, and Zechariah went inside the sanctuary. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared. Zechariah was terrified. "Do not be afraid, Zechariah," the angel said. "God heard your prayer. Your wife will have a son, and you will name him John. His birth will bring you joy. God will be with him. The Holy Spirit will fill him even before he is born." The angel said that John would help many people turn back to God. John would go ahead of the Lord and get people ready for his coming. Zechariah asked the angel, "How can I know this will happen? I'm old and my wife is old." The angel said, "God sent me to tell you this good news because you did not believe my words. You won't be able to speak until these things happen." Zechariah left the temple. The people outside realized he had seen a vision and could not talk. When he was done serving in Jerusalem, Zechariah went home to Elizabeth. In time, she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. Her neighbors and relatives rejoiced. Zechariah and Elizabeth named their son John. Suddenly, Zechariah could speak again. He began praising God. The people who lived nearby could tell that God was with John. The Holy Spirit filled John. Zechariah praised God and told the people God's words. "God has come to help his people. He will save us through David's family. He will rescue us from our enemies." Then he spoke to John, "And you will be called a prophet of the Most High. You will go before the Lord to prepare the way for him." The time had come. God was going to bring his light into the darkness of the world. Peace was coming for God's people. John grew up and lived in the wilderness until God called him to get the people ready for Jesus. When Zechariah believed God's word, he praised God. John was born to prepare the way for Jesus. John would point people to Jesus, and they would praise God for keeping his promise to send the Savior.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kidz. Levi from Blacksburg, Virginia asks,
"What are angels? Why did God create angels?"
Levi, that's a good question because we see angels all throughout Scripture. You know, as you're reading the big story of Scripture, you will see angels time and time again make appearances. And when they appear, they have something important that they're doing. Now, one of the first things that we see them doing is delivering messages. And that is their primary role. That's what they're named after. The word angel actually means messenger. And so God created angels with that primary purpose. Now, let me pause there and say this. Angels are not people. Some people believe that we become angels. That's not true. The Bible says that God created angels differently from people. So we will not become angels. They are different. They are distinct from us. And God created angels again to be his messengers. And that's what we see over and over again. We see that in today's story, where an angel brings a message about the birth of John. We see it with Mary and Joseph, that another angel brings a message about the birth of Jesus. So often we see them bringing messages, but that's not the only thing they do. We also see that angels protect people, they encourage people, they give guidance. And so angels help us live for God, obey him, and understand his ways. So that's the big thing that angels do. That's why God created them. I have a question back for you. So we know that angels have a special role in God's kingdom, but so do you and so do I. The Bible says that we are messengers of Christ. What message does God give us to share with others?
All right, so we just heard about the story of John, who would later, as most people refer to him, call him John the Baptist. And this was a story of how Zechariah did not believe the angel telling him what God had said was going to happen. And so therefore, Zechariah, as you heard in the story, was made into a mute. He couldn't speak. And could you imagine being the people that were outside the temple? Imagine being his wife and trying to figure out, like, what is going on with him? Like, he went in okay, and out he came and he couldn't speak. Like, something must have happened. And you'd be so curious for 9 months that you couldn't actually know what had happened. It would have been crazy. Well, then all of a sudden, John is born, and all of a sudden, then Zechariah can speak, and he says his name is John, and he will be a prophet of the Messiah. And so here's the point of the story, is that John was born in this miraculous way, in the miraculous circumstances, all for the fact of having a purpose, and that purpose was to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. In fact, later on, and later on in stories, you'll see how John sees Jesus coming and says, it's him, he's the Messiah, that I am unworthy to even, like, untie the lace of his sandal. I can't even touch him. He is so worthy of all of our praise. And sometimes, even during this time right now, like, you're stuck at home, you don't get to go to school. I know for some of you that's awesome, other ones of you it's not, but you're stuck at home, and sometimes we go, what can I even do? Like, what's the point of all this? What can I even participate in? You can be a John. You can be someone who tells about the Messiah. You can be the person that looks at neighbors and looks at family members and looks at those around you, and some of you that are old enough to be online with friends, you can look at those people and say, this is who Jesus is, because that's what God is asking you to do today with the story. John was born so that he could prophesy of a coming Messiah. You were born with a purpose to give the good news of the gospel of that Messiah that came to those around you. All right, parents, here are a couple questions that you can talk about with your kids. Number one, how do we get excited about being around Jesus? The story tells us that John, when he was still in his womb and Mary comes to visit Elizabeth, that John leaps inside of the womb because he's understanding that the Messiah is near him. So how do we as a family get excited about the things of Jesus, about the things about God, be it prayer, Bible study, watching videos together and discussing it? How do we get excited about those things? And the second question is this: how do we practice prophesying? Now, I don't mean this is what is coming in the future. I mean, how do we practice telling people about Jesus Christ? Your kids may not know how to give the gospel to their friends because they've never been taught. So maybe this is the time to spend some time talking about, this is how you give your testimony. This is how you talk about Jesus Christ. And the third thing is this: maybe you have some kids in your family that have not accepted Jesus Christ. And right now is the time to ask them, do you know who Jesus is? Is God doing something in your heart? Now, you never want to force a child or force somebody into making a decision, but we do want to give the opportunity when stories like this that talk about the Messiah that has come to save sinners from their sin, we want to give opportunities for people to accept Jesus. So those are the three things I want you to talk about as a family. Last thing, all right, there'll be a couple worship videos after this. If you'd like to use that, some Go Noodle things that just have some get your wiggles out type of stuff, feel free to use those however you like. We use them with our kids at home just for the fun of it. So feel free to use those however you would like. But I did want to let you know that over the next weeks, we'll have different teachers that'll be recording videos that we're going to put on throughout the week. And those will be on Facebook. We may use YouTube to link to them, but we're not going to make a playlist. We're just going to use their videos. It's the teachers that just love your kids and want to share a Bible story with them. So please keep an eye out for that. Please show it to your children whenever you see it come across Facebook, or if you subscribe on YouTube, if you see it come across there, please just make sure that they get to see it, because these teachers miss their students. They miss your kids and they want to tell them that they love them and that they miss them and can't wait to see them, also while telling them a Bible story. So please show that to them if you have the capabilities of doing so. Thank you so much. Guys, have a great week.